Lights, camera, action!
So my little pig tech tripod hold stick holdy thing broke. I broke it. Quite honestly, it was a piece of shit anyway. But, you know, I spent a little too much money on it, so I was like, let me make this work. But yeah, now I don't have like a mini tripod solution, so I gotta figure that shit out. I'm not gonna figure it out anytime soon. Like, that shit can wait. So, you know, I woke up today and had like a new comment under one of my videos, one of my older videos. It's a video about my former upstairs neighbor and her dog. And this person, you know, kind of accosted me. They were just like, the situation must not have really affected you mentally because you're laughing about it in the video. And as a person who truly suffers from mental health issues, you know, it's offensive to people like me. And they were just going on and on. And, you know, my whole thing to that person is, well, two things. Number one, if you are someone who has mental health issues, you deal with stuff, then you should absolutely know that people deal with things in different ways. So while your mental health issues may cause you to like curl up into a ball and hide underneath a blanket in the corner of your bed, right? Maybe I deal with these issues by laughing at them, because the alternative would be to cry or to just crash out in a fit of rage. So I find the best way to release what I'm feeling is to do so through laughter. This is why I've said this in videos, and it's just, you know, a thing that a lot of people I think would feel me on. You know, it's a popular phrase, but you laugh to keep from crying. So please don't come at me or anyone else over how they choose to deal with the issues and problems that whatever is affecting them in their lives. Because you just don't know why they are reacting or dealing with things the way that they are. Everyone's different. Like, when I read that, and, you know, just talking about it now, I laughed because I'm fucking furious. You never know what people are going through. And I marvel at how people on the internet are so, like, they're so brazen, they're so brave, you know, they feel like they can talk shit with impunity. And it's like, you never know, like, the person that you are coming after, you never know what they're dealing with. And I know I've talked about some things in my videos, but there are things that I haven't mentioned. And so don't think that you have the entire story. Don't think that you know everything that I'm going through. Don't think that you know my entire life. And this is with anyone. This isn't just with me. It's just like, you don't know what's going on with anyone. The only person that you know everything that's happening to them in their lives is you. So I would strongly encourage everyone to kind of, you know, follow that little social rule that we have, which is like, you know, treat everyone you encounter with kindness, because everyone is fighting a battle that you know nothing about. That extends to your encounters and exchanges on social media or virtually or whatever. Like, you don't know what folks are going through. So don't fuck with people. You know, right now I'm thinking about my boy who passed away. One of the memorial services just took place. I wasn't able to go, but, you know, a lot of our friends did attend, and I've been like looking at photos and everything, you know, from that service. And, you know, it's just one of those things, you know, grief is funny. Not ha-ha funny, even though I might still chuckle. But grief is funny in the way it'll hit you. Like, just, it's always, like, unexpected. You know, one moment you're picking up a toaster from Target, and then the next thing you know, like, you are on the verge of tears, because... And I've lost people close to me before. It never gets easier. This feeling never goes away. Whether it's a close friend or family member or, you know, whomever, like, it doesn't go away. And at least for me, I feel like this sort of loss really, really, it forces, like, a psychological shift to happen. Like, I can tell you, I am not the same person that I was before my boy passed away. And it's happened with every death of someone who's been close to me, of someone who's been important to me. Like, that's always been the case. You know, for me, it's it triggers a reevaluation of a lot of things. And with that reevaluation, you know, it's just like a sort of re-strategizing my own life, figuring out what's truly important, what do I really want to do, how do I, like, want to maneuver. It's just a reminder of, you know, one's own mortality. And, you know, as I mentioned previously, you know, the thinking that, you know, we always have time and we don't have time. So it's just like, all right, knowing that my time is limited, like, really being faced with that, what is important, what needs to get done. And I mean, like, what good can I do for the world, for the people who are important to me? What work can I leave behind? Or what can I do so that when I'm gone, my actions have improved the lives of whomever? But then also, like, what do I want? What kind of life do I want to have for myself? What can I do? What is going to make me happy? And how can I accomplish that? I'm not lying. I really, really did go to Target earlier to pick up, like, a new toaster and some other shit. And just without warning, just get hit. Therapy. Oh, I promise every video is not going to be like this. All right, I have written a list of things that I need to get done today, so let me get on that. I'm going to end this video on that note. It's going to be a productive day. Going to get shit done. Thank you.